visible?
Yes, visible and
it's visible.
Yes, visible, okay. Audible. Visible,
so that,
audible.
Okay. My sincere thanks to seniors and colleagues of Trichy IAP for their presence and support here. So rational use of antibiotics in pediatric practice is a topic nalla thocha alasi discuss panna topic adu. But ana every time we see a prescription, we realize how little we actually think of whatever we learn, but we fail to implement it in our OPD practice. My sincere thanks to Dr. Kritika Murugesan. Ismail sir sonna odane adutha nimishame avangaloda slides enakku email la anuppitaanga. It made it very, very easy for me to prepare a short presentation myself. Thank you so much, Dr. Kritika. Before we talk about antibiotics, a session on antibiotics is incomplete if we do not pay our respects to this man. This is Sir Alexander Fleming. He went on a short holiday with his family. Kalambi pogumbodhu veetla oru culture plate la staphylococcus valathu uttittu ponaru. When he came back, he saw that the staphylococcal colonies had grown, but there was something else, a mold that was growing on the same plate, which was inhibiting the growth of the staphylococcus. So wherever the mold was present, staphylococcal growth was being inhibited. Wherever the mold was absent in the rest of the petri dish, staphylococcal was growing in abundance. So he knew that there was some factor in the mold which was inhibiting the growth of this bacteria. He called this mold juice. And this was the beginning of having the first antibiotic, penicillin. So in those days, 1928, our penicillin kandupudichaaru. Appave avar sonna vaarthaigal idu. The microbes are educated to resist penicillin, and a host of penicillin fast organisms is bred out. In such cases, the thoughtless person yaare namba. In such cases, the thoughtless person is playing with penicillin and is morally responsible for the death of the man who finally succumbs to infection with a penicillin resistant organism. I hope this evil can be averted. He cautioned not to use penicillin unless there was a properly diagnosed condition for it to be used. And even if you use it, don't use too little and don't use it for a very short period, since these are the circumstances under which bacterial resistance to antibiotics develops. Penicillin kandupidichavare, he warned us against the rampant use of an antibiotic in inappropriate dose and for inappropriate duration. So remember, before God, so namakku ipo if we are able to manage so many diseases, it's because of two reasons. One is because of vaccines and the other is because of antibiotics and intensive care management. So this man comes before God, so let us listen to what he says and start practicing it. So what is the rationale behind an antibiotic prescription? Prescription writing is an art. ஜோசியக்காரங்கள்லாம் எப்படி ஒருத்தங்களோட ஜாதகத்தை பார்த்து அவங்க எப்படி இருப்பாங்க அப்படி இருப்பாங்க அவங்க கடந்த காலம் அப்படி இருக்கும்லாம் சொல்றாங்களோ, நம்ம ஓபியில உட்காந்துக்கிட்டு ஒரு பேஷண்ட் ஒரு பிரிஸ்கிரிப்ஷனோட வெளியில ஒரு டாக்டரை பார்த்துட்டு வராங்கன்னா, அந்த டாக்டர் என்ன மாதிரி டாக்டருங்கிறத அந்த ஒரு சீட்டு பிரிஸ்கிரிப்ஷனை வச்சு நம்ம கண்டுபிடிச்சிடலாம். டேட் இருக்கா, பேஷண்டோட பேரு பார்த்தா புரியுதா, பீடியாட்ரிக் பிரிஸ்கிரிப்ஷன், வெயிட் எழுதியிருக்காங்களா, மெடிசன்ஸ் நமக்கும் புரியுதா இல்ல அவங்களோட பார்மசிஸ்டுக்கு மட்டும்தான் புரியுதா, டோஸ் அண்ட் டியூரேஷன் எழுதியிருக்காங்களா, அண்ட் இஸ் தேர் எனி ரேம்பன்ட் யூஸ் ஆஃப் அன்னெசரி ஸ்டீராய்ட் ஆர் ஆன்டிபயோட்டிக் பிரிஸ்கிரிப்ஷன். இதெல்லாம் பார்த்தாலே இன்னொரு பீடியாட்ரிஷனை பார்க்காமே நம்ம அவங்க என்ன மாதிரி டாக்டர், அந்த ஊர்ல ஒரு டாக்டர் இருக்காங்க, நம்ம பேஷண்ட் அந்த ஊருக்கு போறாங்கன்னா அவங்களுக்கு ரெஃபர் பண்ணி அனுப்பலாமா வேண்டாமாங்கிறத ஒரு சீட்டை வச்சு நம்ம கண்டுபிடிச்சிடலாம். ஸோ யுவர் பிரிஸ்கிரிப்ஷன் ரிஃப்ளெக்ட்ஸ் ஹூ யூ ஆர் அஸ் அ ப்ராக்டிஷனர். இட் இஸ் நாட் ஜஸ்ட் பிட்வீன் யூ அண்ட் த பேஷண்ட், இட் இஸ் கோயிங் அவுட் இன் டு த கம்யூனிட்டி. ஸோ திங்க் பிஃபோர் ரைட்டிங் டவுன் அ பிரிஸ்கிரிப்ஷன். So reasoning for the prescription irkanum. So what is the dose, what is the route going to be, and for how long are you going to write the prescription medicines? Take academically updated decisions, train yourself, train the pharmacist. If this medicine is not available, avanga odane badhilukku vera edho onnu kuduthara koodadhu. They should always remember that they are there to dispense medicines and not to treat the patients. Train the parents. Most often they come back. அடுத்த இல்னஸுக்கு உங்களோட போன வாட்டி வேற ஏதோ ஒரு இல்னஸ்க்கு நீங்க எழுத ஆன்டிபயோட்டிக் சீட்டை கொண்டு வந்து காட்டுவாங்க, டாக்டர் நாங்க வந்து இந்த ஆன்டிபயோட்டிக் எத்தனை 7 நாள் கொடுத்து முடிச்சிட்டோம், உடம்பு இன்னும் சரியாகல. ஸோ வாட் ஆர் வி சப்போஸ் டு டூ நோ, நம்ம இப்போ இன்னும் வேற ஆன்டிபயோட்டிக் போடணுமா, ஆர் டு வி ஹாவ் தி ரெஸ்ட்ரெயின்ட் டு கன்வின்ஸ் த பேரண்ட்ஸ் தட் தி ஆன்டிபயோட்டிக் இஸ் ஆக்சுவலி நாட் நெசசரி ரைட் நோ, அண்ட் கிவ் கிளியர் இன்ஸ்ட்ரக்ஷன்ஸ் டு பேரண்ட்ஸ் வென் டு யூஸ் அண்ட் வென் நாட் டு ரிப்பீட் அ பிரிஸ்கிரிப்ஷன். ஆர்கானிசம் சர்ச் இஃப் பாசிபிள், எவிடன்ஸ் பேஸ்ட் ப்ராக்டிஸ் பண்றது இஸ் பெஸ்ட். நோட் டவுன் த டயக்னோசிஸ். Always in every prescription, there must be an empirical diagnosis. Have a strict antibiotic policy in your hospital or nursing home. Know the local sensitivity pattern. for your community, for the hospital where you practice, as well as the patient. If the patient is having recurrent infections, go back to their investigations, look at the organism that is growing and its sensitivity pattern before you write down an antibiotic this time. And ethical and economic considerations are always important. So ithanaiyum meeri namba yen or prescription la antibiotic ezhudrom? Why do I sometimes write an antibiotic when the picture is clearly viral? My prescription feels incomplete without an antibiotic. Or antibiotic kuda ezhudama or seat namba kudutta apuram eppadi patient ku satisfy aagum? And what if the infection worsens? Avanga pattuku poittaanga na apuram viral infection secondary bacterial aidichuna apuram romba sick aayiruvaangle. ஒரு சேஃப்டிக்கு நம்ம ஆன்டிபயோட்டிக் போட்டுக்கலாம். பாராசிட்டமால் கொடுத்தாலும் ஃபீவர் குறையல, அப்ப கண்டிப்பா we have to give an antibiotic. The mother has already used cefpodoxime from a prescription that you gave last time and now she has come, so she's not going to be happy if you don't give another antibiotic right now and reassure her. So let me write an antibiotic right now. Yesterday I gave amoxicillin and the child has come back today. If I don't add something powerful today, mother is not going to be convinced. Recently there was a child who was admitted with a short febrile illness, 5 days duration. First day cefotaxime, second day ceftriaxone, third day betnasol. This was a pediatric prescription. So what are the common bacterial infections that we are going to go into? URI, upper respiratory infection, lower respiratory infections, acute bacterial rhinosinusitis, acute dysentery, urinary tract infection, skin and soft tissue infections. Idhellam brief ah paapom. All my references are from Nelson. Velila engiyume naan pogala. So upper respiratory tract infection na namba acute pharyngotonsillitis, acute bacterial rhinosinusitis and acute otitis media paaka porom. So MEC-ISAC criteria was initially used in adults, adha modify panni modified center criteria na pediatric practice kaga kondu vandirukanga. A score of 4 or more is indicative of an acute pharyngotonsillitis. So fever irundhadna oru point, tonsil exudate irundhadna oru point, cough illana oru point, anterior cervical lymphadenitis irundhadna oru point. If the age is between 3 and 14 years, you give 1 point. If the age is more than 44 years, you take away a point. Idu oru chinna seat mari namba op la vechitta kuda it will be useful for us. So a 6 year old boy is brought with complaints of high grade fever, odynophagia and sore throat. You do a quick analysis and clinical examination, you know it is acute pharyngotonsillitis. You apply the Centaur scoring, your score is more than 4, so you, if possible, you do a throat swab and culture, and you know that it is group A strep pharyngitis. Rapid streptococcal antigen test ah namba romba pandrathu kadaiyadhu. Treatment is going to be amoxicillin oral 50 mg per kg per day for 10 days duration. Insist on their completing the course even after the child shows clinical improvement. What will happen if I don't treat an acute bacterial upper respiratory infection? Mukkal vasi kondhegal thanave sariyaidum, but namba edukaga antibiotic ezhudrom? First reason is it hastens recovery. It reduces suppurative complications. Moonavathu, if the antibiotic is initiated within 9 days of onset of illness, you will be able to prevent acute rheumatic fever. Acute bacterial rhinosinusitis is a clinical diagnosis. Idhukku investigation edhuvume thevayilla. So when do you suspect? If the child has high grade fever more than 102 with purulent nasal discharge of more than 3 days duration, if the child has rhinorrhea and persistent cough of more than 10 days duration without an improvement, if there is delayed worsening or double sickening, konja improvement aara mari aayita adukaprama child worsen, so it may be a viral infection with a superimposed secondary bacterial infection. Sinusitis la 50 to 60% of the kids will recover without any antibiotic. Antibiotic is given only to resolve symptoms and to prevent suppurative complications. Never ever prescribe azithromycin for a child with sinusitis because there is known to be a high prevalence of antibiotic resistance. Trimethoprim sulfamethoxazole also is not advisable. So a 3 year old child is brought with history of nasal discharge with cough of 10-12 days duration, not improving with symptomatic treatment, so you have given your antitussives and antihistamines, child is not getting better. Your clinical diagnosis is acute bacterial rhinosinusitis. You know the organisms are going to be pneumococcus, H influenza and moraxella. Investigation edume thevayilla. Straight away go off for amoxicillin 45 mg. Adha amoxicillin we have two spectrum, one 45 mg per kg per day. So certain other infections you give 80 to 90 mg per kg per day. So for ABRS we give amox 45 mg per kg per day for 10 days. Certain small group of children ku mattume you give high dose amoxicillin clavulinate. Yaar age less than 2 years, the child is going to daycare, and if there is non response to amoxicillin within 72 hours of initiating, then you give amoxicillin clavulinate 80 to 90 mg per kg per day for a period of 10 days. Acute otitis media. Acute otitis media irundhadhu confirm aachanaale we are going to give antibiotics. There is no role for waiting and watching unless you are uncertain about the diagnosis. So three strong arguments in favor of prescribing antibiotics are: one, acurotatus media is invariably because of pathogenic bacteria. Initiating an antibiotic gives prompt resolution of the symptoms and you're going to prevent suppurative complications. If the age is less than 6 months, you do not have to see pus in the ear. You do not have to see a red tympanic membrane glaring at you. You know that the baby is feeding in the supine position, maybe a bottle-fed baby. Clinically, we have a drag smell, a button press pandra mari press panni kolanda wheel nu kattichina, and you look photoscope vachu namba paaka porom, but 3 maasa kolandhukku kaadu ota vadiya namakku konjonu wax therinjale perusu nareya thara namakku TM tympanic membrane theriyadhu. If you know the child compose panni mother madila vachu feed panna vachittu feed pannum bodhu in the presence of a female staff, if you are a male pediatrician, குழந்தையோட ஒரு ட்ராகஸ லேசா பிரஸ் பண்ணுங்க. இஃப் த சைல்ட் இஸ் நாட் கிரைங், தென் பிரஸ் தி அதர் ட்ராகஸ் ஆஃப் த டியர். இஃப் த சைல்ட் ஜஸ்ட் லெட்ஸ் அவுட் அ ஹை ஸ்க்வீக் அண்ட் ஸ்டார்ட்ஸ் வெயிலிங் இன்கன்சோலபிளி, யூ நோ த சைல்ட் இஸ் ஹேவிங் அக்யூட்டோடைட்டிஸ் மீடியா. யூ டு நாட் ஹேவ் நீட் அ பிக் இன்வெஸ்டிகேஷன் ஃபார் திஸ். ஸோ இன் அ சைல்ட் லெஸ் தேன் சிக்ஸ் மந்த்ஸ் ஆஃப் ஏஜ், யூ ட்ரீட் ஈவன் இஃப் தெர் இஸ் ப்ரிசியூம்ட் அக்யூட்டோடைட்டிஸ் மீடியா. இன் அ சைல்ட் பிட்வீன் 6 to 24 months ஆஃப் ஏஜ் வித் ஹை கிரேட் ஃபீவர், child is toxic and if there is severe ear pain, then you treat. The child is saying that there is ear pain, but the child is looking absolutely comfortable. You can give symptomatic treatment and ask them to come back after 2 or 3 days and reassess. A child with age more than 2 years, only if it is a case of severe acute otitis media or if it is confirmed clinically, namakku paatha TM theriyudhu, you are able to see an effusion or if there is pus coming out or the TM is red, then you are going to start antibiotics. A child less than 6 months of age, even presumed acute otitis media, you're going to treat with high dose amoxicillin, 80 to 90 mg per kg per day for a period of 10 full days. Second line drugs are amoxiclav, cefuroxime. Child has vomiting, child is sick, oral intake kudukka mudiyalana, romba rare ah namba ceftriaxone 3 days ku kuduthukalam admit panni. A child more than 6 months of age, you're going to treat if it is severe or if it is a case of confirmed acute otitis media. What about bacterial pneumonia? The factors to keep in mind for bacterial pneumonia are age of the child, the clinical appearance of the child, OP la treatment pannalama inpatient akkanama, immunization status of the child, that is going to help in identifying what could be the possible organism. A 30% of children with viral infections may have coexisting bacterial infection. So namba first day viral associated VS illana viral LRA with VS nu solrom, symptomatically namba medicines la kuduthe sometimes nebulizer kuduthe anupirrom, they come back on day 3 or day 4 and the child is looking really toxic. It's okay to change our diagnosis at any point of time when we see the child. We do not have to stick to the diagnosis that we have number day 1 la prescription la edina adhe diagnosis than day 3 irukongrada avasiyam kadaiyadu. So always be flexible in your approach. Keep in mind that the child could need antibiotics at any point of time, even in the course of a viral illness. So what is the duration of antibiotics in pneumonia? 10 days azithromycin kudutha mattum dhaan 5 days, adu ideally not less than 10 days. Or you can give it until the child has been affable for a period of 72 hours. In certain centers, you can use procalcitonin to guide you to see if to look for response. A child in the OPD, child is mildly ill, you know it is LRA, but child is not warranting admission immediately, you can give high dose amoxicillin for 10 days. School going children, adolescents, atypical pneumonia we can suspect, so azithromycin kudukalam. So if you have admitted the child and you have a confirmed microbiological diagnosis, then what is the antibiotic tailored for each organism? If it is a strep pneumonia, you're going to give ceftriaxone. Group A streptococcus, also ceftriaxone. Methicillin sensitive staphylococcus, you're going to give cefazolin. MRSA na vancomycin or clindamycin or linezolid. If it is an MRSA which is resistant to clinda, you give the other two drugs, vancomycin or linezolid. Mycoplasma pneumonia, you can start off with IV azithromycin for day 1 or day 2, then change over to oral once the child starts improving. H influenza, you can give ampicillin if it is a beta lactamase negative organism, else you can go in for ceftriaxone. And Nelson talks a lot about minimum inhibitory concentration, so we should all know how to interpret MIC. Minimum inhibitory concentration is the least amount of drug that is necessary to inhibit bacterial growth under controlled conditions. So if the MIC is less, so in itrond marundiliye kekuma is what MIC is. If the MIC is more, it means you need more amount of the drug to inhibit the organism from growing, which means probably developing resistance and the medicine is probably not going to act immediately. What about skin and soft tissue infections? We look at impetigo, bullous impetigo and cellulitis. Impetigo, So topical mupirocin 2% or retapamulin. Retapamulin is a pluromutaline drug. It acts on 50S ribosomal subunit. So if it is a localized impetigo, you use topical mupirocin ointment twice daily for a period of 10 days. If there is widespread staphylococcal involvement, streptococcal impetigo, if the lesions are near the mouth and you cannot apply mupirocin, or if there is an abscess, you give cefalexin for 10 days. If you're suspecting an MRSA organism, then you give clindamycin or doxycycline. Cellulitis or necrotizing infection. So if it is severe, you have to think of one thing is for many physicians, adult and pediatric, when we use antibiotics in a case of a suppurative infection, we always wait for the antibiotic to act. It is not wrong as long as the child is not worsening. But if the pus collection is going to increase, if the child is going to become more toxic, more septic, then it is imperative that we get a surgical opinion that sometimes aggressive surgical debridement can be life-saving. So emergency surgical debridement should always be kept in mind. It's okay to have a surgical intervention, drain the pus, and then allow the antibiotic to act rather than wait indefinitely, change the antibiotic. No, sometimes it's okay to not wait. So if it is severe necrotizing infection, you go in for emergency surgical debridement if advised so by the surgeon. Start off with vancomycin and piperacillin tazobactam, because vancomycin is for gram-positive bacteria. Piperacillin tazobactam is going to cover the gram-negative ones. You start with this, take off your cultures immediately, and then you proceed based on your culture and sensitivity report. You can always change. If it's a moderate cellulitis, then you go in for ceftriaxone, penicillin, or clindamycin. Mild infection, oral cefalexin, dicloxacillin, or oral clindamycin is enough. So one thing is get surgeon's opinion at any point of time. If you think it is okay to get, and if a surgeon advises debridement, just go ahead. The child is anyway going to get better because of the debridement. And follow up on the culture and sensitivity report. Many places, we do not take a blood culture before starting an antibiotic. Starting from NICU, CRP eduthiruvom, CBC panniruvom. Adhellam paathu CRP positive na antibiotic aarambichiruvom. CRP negative irundhalum na antibiotic aarambichiruvom. But ana the culture enna agudhunu we don't see. We do look at clinical improvement, but culture is very, very important. So our staff also should be trained. Ma, na culture edun sollana kuda na antibiotic sonna na enak phone panni kelu. Sir, na blood culture eduthirava appdinu oru vaartha ketta apparama ni antibiotic first dose poduma appdinu we should always train our staff so that there is nobody misses in the system. Next, we go on to GI, acute infectious diarrhea. So this is, Nelson gives it organism wise. So most of our diarrhea, most of it is watery, loose stool, no blood in the stool. You know, it is going to be a viral diarrhea. There is no need to succumb to the same stress as the mother and start an antibiotic. We can wait. We have to reassure them. We should tell them it's going to last for 7 to 10 days. And give them electrol and ask them to monitor for signs of dehydration. And if they're so anxious, ask them to come and review once in 2 days. But starting an antibiotic is not going to help the cause. So if it is the Shigella, then we go in for ciprofloxacin, ceftriaxone, or azithromycin, or a second-line drug is cefixime. Enterotoxigenic E. coli is azithromycin or ciprofloxacin. Non-typhoidal salmonella, na namaku stool culture la report vandhadina, you use it only for age less than 3 years, HIV positive, 3 months, age less than 3 months, HIV positive patients, any other immunocompromised disease status. In the mari irundha mattum dhaan namba non-typhoidal salmonella ku we are going to give the same antibiotics as seen in Shigella. But for a normal immunocompetent person, do not treat. It's usually self-limiting. Yersinia ku, it's usually a self-limiting infection. Ceftriaxone vandu only if the child is becoming bacteremia irundhathu, and if it's an invasive infection, then only you start ceftriaxone. Clostridium difficile appdinu paathona, you discontinue the antibiotic which is causing the problem. Then you start the child on vancomycin or metronidazole for a period of 10 days. So this is a classical case of what we see in summer. A 10-month old baby girl is brought with watery loose stool for the last 3 days. There's initially vomiting, now no vomiting. Mother has not given breast milk to the child because pal kuduthale baby loose stool pohudhunu. Child is irritable and child has passed urine only 4 hours before. This is clearly a dehydrated child. You know that there is no blood in stool, that there is some dehydration, and you know that the cause is viral. There is absolutely no role to give antibiotic to the child. Next, we go on to urinary tract infection. Cystitis, simple UTI, complicated UTI. So acute cystitis, send off a urine culture, start a preservative treatment with one of the three drugs, trimethoprim sulfamethoxazole, nitrofurantoin, or amoxicillin. This is all okay for a simple cystitis. Ask them to come back after 3 days. Look at the culture report and then change the antibiotic. Whatever is going to be the final antibiotic that you're deciding on, total duration of treatment for cystitis alone is 5 days. Acute febrile UTI, you have to decide between oral and IV antibiotic. Child is stable, having all symptoms of acute febrile UTI, but child does not want admission. There's no vomiting. Child is hydrated, able to take orally. Then you go in for oral antibiotic. If these conditions are not satisfactory or the age is too young, you go in for admission and IV antibiotics. Look at the previous urine culture reports. There are children who have recurrent UTI. Previous organisms எல்லாமே பார்த்தா எல்லாமே ரெசிஸ்டன்ட் ஆர்கானிசம்ஸ் ஆயிருக்கும். ஸோ இந்த வாட்டி நமக்கு ரெசிஸ்டன்ட் ஆர்கானிசம் இருக்க போகுன்னு தெரிஞ்சதுன்னா வி கேன் ஹிட் ஹார்ட் அண்ட் ஹிட் ஃபாஸ்ட். வி கேன் ஸ்டார்ட் தி ஆன்டிபயோட்டிக் பேஸ்ட் ஆன் த ப்ரீவியஸ் கல்ச்சர் ரிப்போர்ட் அண்ட் தென் அஃப்கோர்ஸ் வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு சென்ட் அனதர் கல்ச்சர் திஸ் டைம். ஸோ ஓரல் ஆன்டிபயோட்டிக் வி ஸ்டார்ட் வித் செஃபிக்சைம் ஆர் செஃபலெக்சின். அவாய்ட் நைட்ரோஃபியூரன்டாயின். நம்ம அக்யூட் சிஸ்டைட்டிஸ்ல வி கிவ் நைட்ரோஃபியூரன்டாயின், பட் அக்யூட் ஃபெப்ரல் யூடிஐ வேர் யூ திங்கிங் ஆஃப் பைலோநெஃப்ரைட்டிஸ், நைட்ரோஃபியூரன்டாயின் டஸ் நாட் ரீச் சிக்னிஃபிகண்ட் concentration in the renal tissue. So you avoid the drug. Admit panna, you give ceftriaxone or cefotaxime. All this is for a period of 7 to 14 days. As soon as you give the first dose of antibiotic in a child with culture positive UTI, the urine is going to become completely clear within 24 hours. So over 3 days, kalichi improvement paakaren solli innoru urine culture edukkiradhu sutta waste, because the urine culture is going to be sterile after a single dose of the appropriate antibiotic. So there's no point in repeating as long as you have taken a first culture before starting the first dose of antibiotic. There is no role of antibiotic prophylaxis in a child with first episode of pyelonephritis when the child is having an anatomically normal urinary tract. Suppose you have a 1-year-old child who's having a first episode of culture positive UTI. You've done your urine culture, ultrasound, DMSA, MCU, எல்லாமே பண்ணிட்டோம். யூரினரி ட்ராக்ட் இஸ் நார்மல் தெரிஞ்சிருச்சு. தேர்ஸ் நோ ஸ்கிரீனல் ஸ்காரிங், VUR கிடையாது. ஸோ தேர் இஸ் அப்சல்யூட்லி நோ ரீசன் டு புட் த சைல்ட் ஆன் யூரோபிரோஃபைலாக்சிஸ். நாட் டு பி மிஸ்ட் கில்லர்ஸ், தேர் ஆர் மெனி கண்டிஷன்ஸ் வேர் த சைல்ட் பிகம்ஸ் வெரி சிக், வேர் யுவர் இமீடியட் ஆன்டிபயோட்டிக்கை விட மற்ற ஃபேக்டர்ஸ் ஆர் மோர் இம்பார்ட்டன்ட் இன் மானிட்டரிங் அண்ட் இன்டென்சிவ் கேர். அக்யூட் என்செஃபலைட்டிஸ் சிண்ட்ரோம், டாக்ஸிக் ஷாக் சிண்ட்ரோம், டெங்கி என்செஃபலோபதி, ஆல் திஸ் so many of these diseases are overlapping and the season overlap agumbodhu many things tend to resemble the other. So antibiotic alone may not be the solution for many conditions. And of course surgical emergencies, golden hour, koranda casualty ku vanda odane namba op la paathirpom child sick ah irupanga, namba staff kitta sollittu instructions ellame ezhudiruvom, guideline potrunga in the investigation la eduthirunga, antibiotic ezhudirken paathu vaangi potrunga, எல்லாமே நம்ம சொல்லிடுவோம். அந்த குழந்தை கேஷுவாலிட்டிக்கு போய் லைன் போடுறதுக்கு ஒரு அரை மணி நேரம், லைன் போட்டதுக்கு அப்புறமா அவங்களுக்கு அப்பாவை ரிசப்ஷனுக்கு அனுப்புவாங்க ரூம் போடுறதுக்கு. ஸோ ரூம் போடுறதுக்கு ஒரு 20 நிமிஷம். அந்த குழந்தை கல்ச்சர் இங்கேருந்து எடுத்து அனுப்பிடுவாங்க, பட் குழந்தை மேலே ரூமுக்கு போய் அங்கே சிஸ்டர் வந்து இன்டென்ட் போட எழுதி அனுப்புவாங்க, இந்த ப்ரிஸ்கிரிப்ஷன்லாம் எழுதி கீழே ஃபார்மசிலேருந்து போய் வாங்கிட்டு வாங்க. ஸோ கீழே அப்பா போய் வாங்கிட்டு வந்து ஆன்டிபயோட்டிக் இங்கே ஆரம்பிக்கிறதுக்கு குழந்தை ஹாஸ்பிட்டலுக்குள்ள நுழைஞ்சு நம்ம பார்த்து கிட்டத்தட்ட ஒரு 1.5-2 மணி நேரம் கழிச்சு தான் a child with sepsis gets the first dose of antibiotic. This delay has to be averted. This may make a difference to 1 in 10 children. Remaining 9 will do invariably well, but that one child, it may be life saving. So always, always start, take a blood culture, adequate blood volume blood culture before starting the first dose of antibiotic. Ensure that the first dose of antibiotic is given in the casualty itself. Because ward ku pona it becomes very difficult, there is an inordinate delay. So as far as possible, at least in pediatrics, you can tell the casualty staff, give the first dose of antibiotic before shifting to ICU or to the room. These are all small things. If we implement, it will make a large difference in this, the way the system works. So if there is no response to antibiotic, so in a first day cefotaxime, second day ceftriaxone, third day betnazole, so if there is no response to antibiotic, what do you do? First, see, we all make mistakes, and the child may have one symptom resembling one disease on day 1, and the child may have another symptom resembling the actual disease only on day 3. So it is okay to revisit the diagnosis. It is okay to keep changing as long as we document everything in the case sheet. 4 varsham kalichu vera avanga case sheet paathanga na ivar edhukku first day idha potu fourth day adha potrukkaru nu avangalukku puriyanum. So as long as you note your observation and you justify what you're doing, it is okay to revisit the diagnosis at any point of time during the course of treatment. as long as it benefits the child. Revisit culture reports. The child is not improving, go back and see if the culture has been taken. Follow up what is the culture report. Recalculate the drug dose. So if many a time we the number medicine eluthrom medicine staff kudukranga but namba eluthradha dhaan kulandhukku poga dhaan nare thara namba bedside ninna paakradhe kadaiyadhu illaya we it's a way we have been trained. So it's their duty, the staff nurse's duty to load the medicine and to give the infusion. But many often we don't verify to see if that is what is going. So everybody, and especially in COVID times, lot of people have been out of jobs. Hospitals are also under a lot of stress. So they are trying to achieve a lot of good work with a less number of support staff. So the staff are also very stressed. There is a high chance of mistakes happening in this period of time, more than at any other period of time. So it's not about fault finding. It is about filling the gaps in the system. So whenever possible, not all of us are, we're all not very, very busy. Thanks to COVID, lakme practice konja paduthiruchu. So we can actually take some time to see what drug is by the bedside. Make sure namba agent da anga irukudangaradhu oru vaati check panniranga. So think about the choice of drug. Namba first day agentome idu inda kulandhukku enak actually thevaya idive okay va. Check the bedside, then justify the need to change the antibiotic. If you are changing, please document. The role of documenting has not been stressed enough. Avoid polypharmacy. Two, three drugs. Elladukkume kekkara mari namba oru sila prescriptions varum. So avoid polypharmacy. Targeted treatment at the appropriate dose is always welcome. As far as possible, if you're suspecting bacteremia, no role of steroid. There are a few children with acute lymphoreticular malignancies who present to us with fever and with increased inflammatory markers. That child, if a peripheral smear has been done on day one of admission, a good lab is going to pick out the blast. But if somebody outside has given steroids to the child, tappuna fever korayanam, give steroids, the blasts are going to disappear from the smear. Your diagnosis is going to be delayed. You're going to give antibiotics for 5 days. You're going to wait for culture. The child is going to worsen, platelets are going to drop. Then you're going to get somebody's opinion, or then you're going to do a bone marrow. Everything is delayed because one of us chose to give steroids. So as far as possible, please remember the role of steroids in our practice is very, very limited. It must be very, very choosy. So amma coming, I am sick. The kids are all sick. I can't sleep. There's so much coughing. I can't cope. Surely an antibiotic will help. So we are all under a lot of pressure to satisfy our clients. Namba vaidyam pandrathu paadina avangalukku console panni kondha pathi bayapada vendanu warning symptoms solli avangala reassure pandrathu dhaan innum paadi vaidyam. So but at the same time, our patients, I have learned this from Dr. SBS, my teacher. They are all used to him. They are all used to his way of practice. His patients will not come and nag him for antibiotics even after 4-5 days of fever. They all know. This is the way we practice, and they will understand. When we start succumbing to the pressure, we lose track in the way. And it's very difficult to get on track and practice medicine ethically. So thank you all for your patient listening. I've stuck to time. Thank you so much for the opportunity, Ismail sir.
Thank you, Dr. Sudhasar. That was a really wonderful talk. Da eppadi the presidential action plan la think pannano or peripheral practitioner ku eppadi idu edu kudukkanum gnaradu. I think ஒரு கிடிப்புள்ளைக்கு பாடம் எடுத்த மாதிரி பீங் அன் என்விரான்மெண்டலிஸ்டா என்னன்னு தெரியல. நீங்க அவ்வளவு அழகா ஒரு ஒவ்வொரு பிராக்டிஷனருக்கும் சொல்லி கொடுத்தது, எஸ்பெஷலி கொலோக்கியலா தமிழ்ல அழகா பேசுனது வந்து மனசை தொட்டது. நாட் ஓன்லி தட், ஐ திங்க் இட் இஸ் மேட்டர்ஸ் எனி யூ கேன் லெக்சர் சோ மச், பட் ஒன்லி திங் இஸ் இட் ஹேஸ் டு ரீச் த பீப்புள்ஸ் ஹெட். அஃப்கோர்ஸ் த வே யூ ஹேட் பிராட் அவுட் இன் சச் வே இன் அ வெரி சிம்பிள் லாங்குவேஜ், I think people will really understood the different spectrum of diseases and the way what antibiotic should be chosen, how long should be given, and what are all the precautions you should take, and what is mean by the golden hour, not to miss in the bedside manners, what, how to see a patient, everything you dealt in such a good way. I think the practitioner would be really benefited for that. So thanks for your wonderful lecture.
Thank you very much, sir.
I don't see any questions in the screen. I would request Dr. Raghavan to say a few words, a comment from Raghavan, Trichy branch president.
Good evening, everyone. Thanks, Sudarshana, for that was a beautiful lecture.
Thank you, sir.
And you spoke very well, covered all the points. And like sir said, you covered about the golden hour, starting immediately the antibiotic, which we don't do generally. You stressed upon that. And I would like to really congratulate Dr. Ismail for the persistent perseverance with which he is going through this PERS, insisting that all the branch, all the subspecialties do, all of our branches do it, and we repeat it till it goes into our head. Congratulations to you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you, Raghavan. I think having taken up, I think we need to be persistent and consistent also.
It's a very nice quality you have, sir.
Thank you. I do see the presence of Aram Sandil, past president, my good friend, I think. Sandil?
Yes, Ismail. Yeah, I'm here.
Yeah,
it was a wonderful presentation by Dr. Skanda.
Thank you, sir.
She's always wonderful, and I know her. And only one query, a practical point. Before giving an antibiotic, every time, what is your practice and what is the advice usually? Every time you give a test dose, or how do you go about it practically?
Sir, naan work pandra nursing home la vandu, it is a practice adult hospital adu. Avanga adhe dhaan pediatrics ku follow pandranga. So adanalla ellarkum avanga test dose kuduthirtha antibiotic kudukranga, sir. That is what I have seen. Naan sonnade illa, but avanga adhaan pandranga.
Okay. Illa adu, will it go for a delay? Nee sonninga illaya, and immediate and the casualty le first dose kuduthirunga appdi sonninga. So, அதுக்கு வந்து ஒரு டிலே வந்துருது அப்படிங்கிறது தான் என்னுடைய கன்சர்ன்.
நம்ம ஒரு செப்டிக் ஷாக்ல ஒரு சைல்டு பார்க்கும்போது நம்ம ஐ திங்க் வி கேன் இட் இஸ் ஆல் அன் இண்டிவிஜுவலைஸ் திங் சார். டாக்குமெண்டேஷன் இஸ் இம்பார்ட்டன்ட். ஐ திங்க் யூ ஜஸ்ட் பைபாஸ் த டெஸ்ட் டோஸ் அண்ட் யூ கேன் கிவ் ஆஃப் த ஃபர்ஸ்ட் டோஸ் ஆஃப் ஆன்டிபயோட்டிக் ஃபார் அ சைல்ட் இன் செப்டிக் ஷாக் இன் த கேஷுவாலிட்டி.
ஓகே. Thank you.
Yes sir. Thank you sir.
Thank you Sindhil. I think Shiva is there.
Yes, sir.
Dr. Lakshminarayan, sir, please unmute. Unmute, sir. JLN, sir, unmute.
Test dose.
Yes, sir.
Is only a legal escape. It doesn't help anybody.
Sir,
legal escape. But... For any drug, for that matter. And test dose, kuduthudan sir potta. Adhanaala appo I'm escape from the punishment. அதுக்காக போடும். Test dose doesn't give any benefit at all. Even those days of penicillin, test dose போட்டுட்டு கொடுப்போம், அப்பவும் ஷாக் வரத்தான் செய்யும்.
I think I do agree, sir. But actually, after the Consumer Protection Council, kula namba
vandadhilirundhu,
a lot of practicing methods have changed.
That's why I call it a legal escape.
Yes, sir. I do agree with that. Thank you, sir. Thanks for your comment. Shiva?
Sir, good evening, sir.
Right.
Sir, illa sir. Good evening, sir.
Okay.
So, it's a very good presentation. So,
thanks,
I had
Shiva.
One doubt. So, even though I am in
WHO.
So, WHO and IMNC guidelines says, for the treatment of dysentery, first-line ciprofloxacin, being the pediatrician, we are using only the cefixime. Since nowadays fluoroquinolones usage is little bit reduced.
Amma.
Not little bit, almost totally reduced since being a second line drugs for TB.
Amma.
And if refractory to cefixime, we can go for azithromycin as mentioned Palliraman sir in one meeting. So what's your experience, whether you are using cipro or ofloxacin or only cefixime?
My teachers have not used cipro. So, I cut copy paste of my teachers. I have never used Cipro. So, okay. My choice has always been cefixime.
Okay. Good. The presentation was very nice as your own style.
Thanks, Shiva.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you all of you. I think there are no more questions. I think, is there anything? I have to check it up in the chat box. No. It's only compliments for Dr. Sudarshana. Thank you, Dr. Sudarshana. Thank you, the Trichy people and all the delegates who have attended this meeting. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Shiva.
Thank you, sir.